Today we're talking about the Kodak Brownie Funsaver camera. This came out in 1963. There was also a version that came out in 1960. I think they just called it Kodak Brownie 8. It is a manual. You wind it. And then here is your shutter button. Ooh.
Purrs like a kitten.
It does purr. And this is a beautiful camera that takes really sharp home movies. And it's super simple. It has f-stops. Can you see?
Sure.
Do you see any f-stop numbers? The widest opening is f2.7, and it goes down to, hold on, clicks on down to somewhere between f16 and f22. I suggest you use a light meter app on your phone, or use a handheld light meter, or black cat exposure guide, because you'll want to dial in your shutter speed. You may say, well, what? These cameras, what is the shutter speed? 1/30th of a second. So once you know it's 1/30th of a second, and you know it's f2.7, and then you know the speed of your film, you're all set. You can figure it out. On the side of your camera is a lever. This is your film counter. It tells you when your film is out. And let's talk about that for a second. When you open up the side of the camera, there is the film compartment. Now, this takes regular 8mm film. Regular 8mm film is, when you shoot it, 16mm wide, double perfed. So essentially, what you're doing is loading your camera with 16mm film, but it's not 16mm film, it's 8mm film. And just that is important because the regular 8 cameras will not take standard 16mm film. Because you may get, you know, you may be smarty pants and be like, well, you know, I'm just going to put 16 through it. You can't. You must use double 8 film. It's perfed specifically for 8mm cameras. Let's really quick show how to load this camera.
So your roll goes here in the Kodak Funsaver Brownie. And it has a path here, which when you run the motor, you're going to put your film in there. And you take your film and you put it behind what's known as the film gate. I kind of felt it click into place. So this should be loaded. Let's see. Beautiful. Yes. So and you can see there are arrows here that the spool is going to turn this way. And this is the take-up spool. It says side one. Because when you're done shooting this side, you will take this and flip it and then shoot it again, hence the name double eight. So I'm going to put this, I don't know if you can see it, there's a little slot here. You can put your film in, and then you carefully whoop, see that? I did not put it on properly. Okay, good. Oh boy. A little tricky. Tricky, tricky, tricky. Let's try this now. There are little guides here of where you're supposed to keep a loop. You want to keep a little loop so that the film gets guided onto the take-up spool properly. I know it's easy to get the film sweats with this, but I feel very confident. So, great. You can do this in dim light. Then you put your lid on. Come on! Don't. And then this you close. And then as you close it, when you close it, becomes your frame counter. You start at 25. It's not at 25. I don't know what that means.
25 feet.
25 feet. And then it'll come to E empty. And then you'll open this up, flip it, and then shoot the other side.
So when you're done shooting, you're going to wind up with a roll of film that looks like this. You can load and unload the film in dim light or shade. This is called a daylight spool. It keeps the light out. You know, definitely not in sun. Don't do it in sun. And then once you shot both sides, you put it back in its tomb. You send it to the lab for yourself, process it. What film is available? Well, we have 100 speed black and white reversal by FOMA, 100 ISO. This has been around for many years. And this year, brand new, FPP will be introducing our own Cine 8, which I'm very excited about. And this is a 50 ISO black and white reversal film. And soon we'll have a color 50 ISO negative film. That's all very exciting. It is a great year to shoot regular 8mm film. There are lots of other camera choices. If you go to eBay and type in 8mm film camera, you're going to see a boatload of little guys like this. This is a Revere 88. I had one. John had one. Millions of these were probably made. And just like the Brownie, gets wound up, and you shoot. And just like the Brownie, it's almost identical. It's laid out a little bit differently, but it's almost identical. That's really it. Introduction to 8mm filmmaking. Here is some footage that I shot recently at the FPP podcast recording sessions. If you have any questions, Michael at filmphotographyproject.com. I hope this was helpful. See you next time. My name is Michael at filmphotographyproject.com. If you want to drop me an email, and we'll see you soon.